The lesson is found on page 2 in the Deliverance book. And I will be quoting some scriptures and teaching some scriptures from page 2 in the Deliverance book. We're going to start teaching on page on Hebrews 11 and 1. And our subject is going to be called the Deliverance. And we're going to read Hebrews 11, and we're going to see faith and the patriarchs of faith and how God recognized and how God deal with faith. Hebrews 1. There's a time element there. Now, Hebrews 11 and 1. Now, faith is the substance of the things hoped for. Faith is the evidence of things not seen. For by faith, the elders obtain a good report. Hebrews 11 and 3. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hebrews 11 and 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain his brother, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it he being dead yet spake. By faith, Hebrews 11 and 5, by faith Enoch was translated, taken up out of here, that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony, just the only testimony he had, that he pleased God. That's the only testimony we need, that we please God. Hebrews 11 and 6, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. He that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. Faith. Hebrews 11 and 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whither he went. By faith, he sojourned in a land of promise as a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles. Look, here's his generation. Dwelling in tabernacle with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. Three generations. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. 10th verse, Hebrews 11. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is God. He's looking for heaven. Through faith also, Sarah, that old woman, herself, received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child, look, when she was past age, about 100 years old, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Hebrews 11:12, therefore, spring there even of woman in him as good as dead, so many as stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the sea show innumerable. These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off and were persuaded of them and embraced them and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country, looking forward to the end of their life for the beginning of their salvation. Hebrews 11:15. And truly, if they had been mindful of that country from which they came out, they might have had opportunity to have returned. But now they desire a better country, that is, an heavenly. Wherefore God is not ashamed, look, to be called their God. For he had prepared for them a city by faith. Abraham, when he was tried, offered up Isaac, and he that had received the promise offered up his only begotten son, of whom it was said that in Isaac shall thy seed be blessed. So he had that promise. You don't have no seed, you're going to have one. When you have a seed, you're going to call him Isaac. And Isaac is going to populate the whole earth. Hebrews 11:19. According to that, God was able to raise him up, even from the dead, from which also he received him in a figure. 20th verse in Hebrews 11. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob. And here's what people don't like to read. Hebrews 11:20. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, man dying, still believing on God. Hebrews 11:21. By faith, Jacob, when he was in the process of dying, blessed both the sons. What sons? Joseph and Esau. 21st verse in Hebrews 11. By faith, Jacob, when he was a dying, blessed both the sons of Jacob and worshiped, leaning upon the top of his staff. Couldn't stand, just leaning on that staff. That staff was a type of the Holy Spirit. By faith, Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandments concerning his bones. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents. Why? because they saw he was a proper child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. Any child born in a certain day was to be destroyed. Hebrews 11:24. By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasure of sin for a season, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt, for he had respect unto the recompense of the reward. By faith, he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible, looking to God that he couldn't even see. Through faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he that destroyeth the firstborn should touch him. By faith, Hebrews 11:29, by faith they passed through the Red Sea as by dry land. There was no water in that Red Sea, which the Egyptians are saying to do, were drowned. Our subject is deliverance, and we're in our Bible, Hebrews 11, the 30th verse. By faith, the walls of Jericho, you could set 5-4-horse team rigs up there and race around that wall that was so wide. But Hebrews said, in Hebrews 30, by faith the walls of Jericho fell, look, down, not over. You catch a wall big enough to race 4 or 5 teams of horses on that wall. If it fall over, you couldn't get over it. See, God is not logical. He's miraculous. The wall then fall over. It fell straight down in the ground, level with the ground. Now, if Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, look like to me, we ought to be able to take care of this teeny weeny problem that we have. What I'm doing, I'm allowing the baby to be a baby. What people do now erroneously, they take the babies and put them in the basement and teach them how to pin the tail on a donkey. That makes them an ass too. When the Bible says, bring up the children in the way they ought to go, how can you bring them up in absence of the Word of God? Take him out of the Bible study into a playroom. No, man. The disciples got rebuked by Jesus. Because the little baby, they didn't care who y'all did. You love them. They just come run up on you and kiss you. The little baby's running and hugging Jesus. And disciples rebuked the little babies and made Jesus angry. Suffer means permit. Permit the little children to come unto me and forbid them not. That ain't just back there. There's a school up there on the street close to us. One little boy, 5 or 6 year old, got a hold to a gun and killed a little girl, 5 or 6 years old. Now, if both of those children had been in Sunday school, never mind, let them go to sleep. They can receive more gospel in 5 minutes than it takes us 2 hours to receive. Because we're going to consider, well, if it, when I was, now she said, I said, I believe, well, my other pastor said, When the babies hear it, they take it and go to sleep. So Jesus said, permit the little children to come into me. And forbid them not. Look what he said. For such are the kingdom of God. So you're going to bring a child to church and sit him next to you. Warn him before you leave home. Now, if you act up, I'm going to spank your tail. When children be children, they ain't acting up. They're acting their age. Now, when their grandmother start acting like that, I'm going to call the police. I'm going to call Jesus. Something is wrong because granny has failed. She has failed to hear and obey the leadership of the Holy Spirit. And we got this thing, it's erroneous. We think church is a quiet atmosphere thing. When Jesus said, make a joyful noise, all you land, shout. Amen. With the voice of triumph and say, glory to God. That's the church. You see how quiet certain people got? I know what I'm doing. Just leave me alone. Just leave me alone. God, no. Nobody can come into a Holy Ghost Bible teaching church and interfere with the Bible. Nobody. Nobody. God won't permit. Now we need to get this. He said, permit the little children to come. He said it. Then he made it, flipped it over, and forbid them not. For such, not is in the kingdom, such is the kingdom of God. Hey, when I was a little baby, that had been a couple of years ago, my grandfather was a preacher, and I would lay in the pulpit in front of my grandfather, sucking on a bone of a chicken leg. They take that knuckle off so you can't swallow, and I'm laying down there, both of my legs and feet going, sucking on. Nobody said nothing. I am the only child in that family that is a minister. Other people sitting in the pew, shut up, boy, shut up. You hear the preacher? No, you don't hear the preacher. Freedom. 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 I'm in Hebrews 11. I'm going to start at the 20th verse again in Hebrew 11. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau. They were half brothers, had different mothers. Concerning things to come, by faith, Jacob, when he was dying, bless both the sons of Joseph. Bless both the sons of Joseph and worshiped in the process of dying, leaning on the top of his staff. Dying. Dying. Praising God. Boy, that's a good way to enter into the kingdom, man. Hebrews 11:22. By faith, Joseph, when he died. Understand this scripture. Hebrews 11:22. Don't read by faith before Joseph died. Hebrews 11:22. said, by faith, Joseph, when he died, after he died. Don't try to correct it. Made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandment concerning his bone after he was dead. Ain't that right, Pastor? Is that way it is?
Amen.
All you got to do is slow down. This book will teach you.
Amen.
It'll teach you. My little great baby, about that size, in the driveway the other day, say, Granny, I can do a wheelie. Will you stand flat up and flip over like that? His granny said, boy, not on this concrete. He said, pew, turn over like that. I said, good God, about it. Just turn, flip over like that, and came back. Then he said, I told you. His grandmother said, Lord, what am I going to do with this boy? Let him be a boy. And when he get a young man, you ain't got to go to jail to get him out. Because when he was a child, you treat him like he was a child.
Amen.
Until a child coming to the knowledge that we think we got, they're not guilty. It says this. Jesus said, permit the little children to come to me. And don't you prevent them. They crawling in his lap, hugging him, kissing him, pulling his beard, just like Sherman do. Hebrews 11, 21. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, look, before he died, in the process of dying, Hebrews 11, 21, bless both the sons of Joseph and worship leaning upon the top of his staff. Now, look at Hebrews 11, 22 and leave it alone. By faith, when he died, didn't you hear the scripture say when Cain killed Abel, Abel's blood spoke up? It talked. Don't put your head to that. You don't want to know what your address is. Leave that alone. Let God become a such a head. Let God be God. I said, let God be God. I said, let God be God. I said, let God be God. We're in Hebrews 11 and we're talking about the 21st verse. By faith, Joseph, when he died. Now you know English. Died means done died. He ain't here. Not in the process of dying. When he died, he spoke. Boy, that's a miracle right there. This whole book is a miracle, man. Give God a big hand for that. Now you can't go and order some courses on concordance, and you can't find that in them things. You got to slow down and listen for the voice of God, or you ain't gonna never understand nothing. We're dealing with a man now, down in someplace, Atlanta. His intent is to go back to Egypt and find out beginning of his Jewish roots. What? For what? Your mama's a Jew. Your dad is a Jew. But Romans said, he that is a Jew is not justified. But he that's a Jew in his heart. When I go back down there, he know about it. He know about it. So black man got brave and said, how long you and your wife been married? He said, we're going to get married in October. And she made a mistake. He sleep off from under cover. Now, you ain't got to say nothing else about that. But when I said that, look at me. I saw some hands reaching. They want the book. They want this book. And I told you about the woman start taking Blackman's picture. Blackman start teaching. The more he teach, the more she opened her legs like that. Blackman lift his eyes to the sky and start praying. Them legs come back together like that. That woman got up and started shouting, thank you, Jesus. The devil will try you. Amen. Pat your hand if you don't know what I'm talking about. Both of us down there, 800-900 miles away from his wife, our wife, don't know nobody, free day and night, and here come the devil. But you see, we didn't go down there to go to hell. You don't have to drive 800-900 miles to go to hell. Just get bone and don't get bone again. You ain't got set for no effort. Our subject is deliverance, and we're in Hebrews 11. And we hit a nugget here in Hebrews 11:20. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. So Isaac prophesied to Jacob and Esau. Amen. This book is a prophecy, saints. By faith, Jacob, when he was a dying, in process of dying, blessed both the sons of Jacob, of Joseph, and worshiped, leaning upon the top of his staff. Look now, this is a miracle. Hebrews 11:22. Look, you see, the miracle is not in what he did, it's how he did it. Hebrews 11:22, by faith, Joseph. Now don't let this slip you. When he died, that means after he was dead, made mention of this departing of his children of Israel and gave commandment concerning his bone when his body was dead. He spoke from the grave. Amen. We always talk about nothing is too hard for God. Well, leave that alone. Amen. Where do you think the prayer of a sinner come from? A dead soul. Lord, save my soul. My soul is dead, but I'm crying out. You see that, preacher? It's too big for us. I don't care how many doctoral degrees you got, that's too big. You understand that only with the mind of Christ.
Amen.
That ain't Holy Ghost talk. I said, that ain't Holy Ghost talk. Hebrews 11, and we hit this nugget here, and I ain't moving neither. I ain't moving. Hebrews 11, 22. By Joseph, by faith, Joseph, look, when he died, after he was dead, made mention of the departing of his children, of the children of Israel, and gave commandments concerning his bones, though his soul was alive. Bones don't talk, the soul talk. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of the parents, of his parents, because they saw he was a proper child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. As a matter of fact, the king's daughter adopted Moses. Huh?
Amen.
And when Moses got 40, he told him, I'm out of here. I ain't no Greek. I'm going home. Y'all listening?
Amen.
Now listen to me. If you are the king's daughter's son, you can't need for nothing. But 40 years went by. And God spoke to Moses. Go home. Go home. Go home. And this wasn't just a little BB shooting soldier. There never been a soldier greater than Moses. See what gets certain people's attention? 22nd verse in Hebrews 11. By faith, Joseph. Read the next three words with me. When he died. That means after he was dead. Now, I ain't going to stretch that, but I don't think you saw that before. That's why you're here. That's why you're here. Now, I confess to you, I didn't see it neither. This book says, study to show yourself crucified. When you come to this Bible college with a hunger to see God better, it's the Holy Spirit's responsibility to pull the blind off of your eyes. Come on here. What does that say to us when things seem to be impossible? When things seem to be illogical, they just right with God. I heard a man tell a woman, if you're so pretty, how come you ain't married? She turned around and told him, because I'm pretty. She wasn't talking about on the inside. She was talking about what the man was looking at. Her body. I ain't married because I am beautiful. Now what can that say? If you tiptoed, pad-toed, knock-kneed, cross-eyed, slew-foot beautiful, you have a hard time trying to find a husband.
Amen.
You ain't like Susie that put that cot sack down and fried and was married Sunday and been married 75 years. I tell you how come it's like that. Susie been ugly all her life. And she admits it. Susanna was born beautiful. She'll see herself as beautiful. And men will marry that beautiful. But in 20 years, you ain't the woman he married. Because he's looking at how you were. Pat your hand to that with your jive self. But if you're beautiful in Jesus, my Bible said Jesus is the same, yeah? Today, and forevermore. That's how rehab was justified. Because she did good to the men of God. She wouldn't tell the other people that they was hiding. That's beauty. And God opened the doors of heaven to her. And when you get there, you're going to see her. And I'm going to tell you something else. I can't say it for nobody but her and me. When you get to heaven, wait 2 or 3 million years and then ask him, "Are you seen Jane?" He said, "Yeah, he over there on his knees." "What's he praying for?" "He worshiping God." How long he been worshiping God? Eternity, Jesus, so long. You mean he still loved Jesus? There's nothing ordinary with Jesus. You see the peace in this room that the devil tried to translate it as confusion? Amen. Love never fails. And we don't get things right, man. The Lord said, "Love ye one another." Amen. He didn't say, "Except you be a child." Except you be a baby. If Jesus come for his church right now, I would whole lot rather be like that baby there than some of us. You see, I'm an old man. And certain things that irritate other folk bless me. Ha ha! Ha! It bless me. I'm in Hebrews 11 teaching the subject deliverance. And I'm going to start at Hebrews 11:19. I'm going to start at Hebrews 11:17. By faith, Abraham, when he was tried, hold it right there. Do you see what you need when you're tried? Not tongues. Not the Holy Ghost. Not scripture. Faith is the keeping power of God's people. And faith is a positive proclamation in spite of all hell. Peter saw Jesus walk that water. Looking right at him. Here's what he did that crippled his face. He said, "Lord, if that be you." Ha ha ha! Ha! Preposition. not help me, but permit me to come. When you talk to Gamayasatanahe, when you talk to God, you need to know how to approach God in the name of Jesus. I prayed for 3 days, Lord, fix my lawnmower. All four of my lawnmowers are dead, including that $5,000 zero turn. I approached God the wrong way. I said, Lord, show me how to fix my lawnmowers so I can cut your grass. That's a bribery. 3 or 4 days I've been saying that. Went to see my son, Gracie Emanuel, associate pastor over there. I told him, he said, call this man here and tell him I told you to call him. I called him. That man stopped what he was doing, came over here, took those 3 blades off of my lawnmower, turned them over, and the one in the middle, shaka, 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 shaka. I ran over one of them rugs you see when you come in the door out there, and I broke one of the shakas loose. 3 other blades were turning, the one in the middle, I broke the shaft. So, raka, raka, raka. That man came out, he older than me. Got down on his knee. Now, see, she don't go down. When you older than me, you old. He said, I think one of my sisters or something died. He said, I can't fix it, but I'm going to let this man fix it for you. Go this place and order this thing here. I went there. I said, Lord, how come you didn't answer my prayer? He said, what prayer? You were asking me, Lord, help me. I ain't no mechanic. Keep it simple. Lord, fix my lawnmower. Thank you. So when I came to the end, Pastor, see, look, when God don't answer my prayer like I want him answered, tears start coming out of my eyes. Because I realize, Pastor, you ain't asking right. Now we need to know, without the Holy Spirit, we don't know how to talk to God. Come on here. I just heard a scripture. Jesus said, the day you hear my voice, hey, my Satan, hey, harden not your heart as in the day of provocation. When they tried me and saw my judgment 400 years. What I'm telling you, the Bible is right when it tells us cast all your care upon God. He care for you. I wasn't praying, I was begging. Lord, help me fix this lawnmower. Look at the con game. So I can cut your grass. Now you can't bring street talk to God. You can't bring street talk to God. But you can bring sweet talk to God. So I started looking back. I said, Lord, when I was on my way to New York to play a concert and went to sleep with my car on cruise, and I went to sleep and about to hit the viaduct, and You woke me up.
See, look, you got to tell God, you got to bring God to your memory of how good he been.
Amen.
Then you come to the scripture, he's the same. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. You can't con God. We are sweetly hung up on a miracle. I don't know why preachers try to teach miracles in the New Testament. Jesus Christ is saying yesterday, today, what? And forever. Don't put him in a box. Tune it verse. Hebrews 11. By faith, Isaac, look at this word, blessed Jacob, and he blessed Esau concerning thing to come. He prophesied to them. And that prophet was a blessing. It was a guideline. It showed them which way they're supposed to go, what's going to happen, what position they're going to be in, what the king going to do, what the queen going to do. But look what God going to do. Come on here. When did he do that? When he was in the process of dying. He preached the gospel till his last breath, preacher. Hey! Till he died, he was preaching the gospel. But the Methodists or some other churches, Pastor Blackman told me, when you get 65, they fire you. You can't pastor no more. How you gonna retire a saint? Do you see Joseph and Isaac and Jacob? They preached Jesus until their last breath. In Hebrews 11:22, by faith, Joseph, when he died, still instructed the church. Listen now and learn. His body just died. He became alive. His spirit preached the things he knew before his body died. My subject is deliverance. And I'm teaching Hebrews 11. Hebrews 11:22. Now the first two words that you see in all these scriptures, by faith. Faith enabled to him to. But faith alone is dead. Faith in God spoke to Joseph. Faith in God spoke to Jacob. Faith in God spoke to Isaiah. Faith in God speak to us.
Amen.
Faith is the conversation of God. And faith come by hearing, and hearing by this word of God. So when you read God's word, God spoke to you then. So the word of God is nothing less than God laid down flat. When you have faith in a laid down God, that faith would take that laying down God and stand him up. By faith we stand. Without faith we fall. Faith is God. Hear that? Faith is God. We're teaching deliverance now, and we are in Hebrews 11. I'm going to start at the 17th verse again because I'm getting blessed up here. What I am receiving is revelation from God as to what faith really is and what faith is designed to do for the faithful. Amen. So faith comes to anchor you. And if you keep reading this word from that anchor position, you can speak glory. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Thank you. Faith is the savior, the keeper, the inspirer, the teacher, the substance of things what? Hope for in the evidence what? Of things not seen. Faith is all of this. And these patriarchs, they saw all of it. They saw more faith than we can see. And they wrote it. What you need to do now, look here. You can look out there and see faith. But faith cometh. Faith from out there can look here and see us. So faith that you can look and see, and faith that can see you, gives us a faith walk. God said it, that serves it. Glory to God. That's the way it works, man. That's the way it works. Now I need to get real, man. Things don't have to be right for us to live holy. As a matter of fact, when we make up our mind, I ain't doing that sin now kind of more again. Here comes Satan. Ooh. You know you've been admiring that dress for 4 years. God don't mind if he get take your tithe and pay for that. God on that, you better pay your tithes. I say you pay your tithes. Not paying tithes is a key that opened the door of hell.
Amen.
You can't rob God. It is impossible. I'm going to keep telling you this stuff, man. I was on my way to New York City to play a concert when I was a young preacher on one of them seven some son of jets. And I saw an angel. I looked out the window and saw an angel. The angel was so much bigger than that airplane until it took him 15 minutes to pass by. And I wanted to say, did you see? No. See, hey, what God showed you is for you. And God only show you good deeds. And the scripture said, make known the good deeds of the Lord among the people. I ain't gonna never forget that. And I was praying and got caught up in the Holy Ghost. And I left my body and went right there to the doors of heaven. I could see the glory shining through the crack. And I was going, jump in there like that and woke myself up. I said, Lord, oh God. I heard God say, it's not time. That's been 40 years ago. I've already outlived Paul, Peter, John, those people. But here I am at 82, reading what those young men wrote over 2,000 years ago. It is simply amazing, boy. And I've been studying a long time, but I didn't know. Hebrews 11:22. You didn't either. Don't be lying in here. By faith, Joseph, when he died, after he was dead. Well, how come that's so amazing? When on earth, God don't speak to your flesh. So when the Holy Ghost put his fingers in the ears of your flesh, and you start seeking God with your heart, don't rush God. Now don't go home and tell God, now Lord, Pastor Wheeler said, you seek the Lord for you. You can do it better for you than I can for you. And once God touched your stuff, nobody can tell it like you. Oh, nobody. Nobody can tell it like you. And you'll be saying, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I'm going to tell you again. I prayed for 3 days for God to show me how to fix those lawnmowers. God didn't show me nothing but another minister, my son, Jeff. And I went to Jeff's church to give him a few dollars to help him with his son's wedding. And I told my son about this lawnmower. He said, call this number. I called that number. That man's something busy, but I'll be there. Just like that, he came to do this. Learn the scripture. Learn. Just don't put them in your head.
Pastor Dr. James L. Wheeler here, president and founder of Mighty FGCC Bible College Theological Seminary in this country and abroad. 48 colleges spread it throughout, nothing but the Word of God. I pastor the Full Gospel Christian Church at 5901 Dr. Martin Luther King and Home Avenue, 3 blocks north of Pearson Road, where you're always welcome on this television station every Sunday morning from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m., every Wednesday night from 9 to 11 p.m., Sunday school 9:30, morning service 11 o'clock, evening service 7 p.m., Tuesday Bible College from 7 to 10, 1 night, 3 hours, rather than 3 nights, 1 hour, Thursday night, both study and prayer. We're on WFLT every Sunday morning at 8, every Saturday morning at 11. This is a place where you hear nothing but the Word of God. Come.
Glad to have our young baby students with us. We want this to act like a real church, real people, not shh people, but hallelujah people. We're going to be teaching out of the textbook now, and Deliverance, you don't need your textbook if you follow me. The lesson is found on page 2 in the Deliverer's book. And I will be quoting some scriptures and teaching some scriptures from page 2 in the Deliverance book. We're going to start teaching on page on Hebrews 11 and 1. And our subject is going to be called the Deliverance. And we're going to read Hebrews 11, and we're going to see faith and the patriarchs of faith and how God recognized and how God deal with faith. Hebrews 1. There's a time element there. Now, Hebrews 11 and 1. Now, faith is the substance of the things hoped for. Faith is the evidence of things not seen. For by faith, the elders obtain a good report. Hebrews 11 and 3. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hebrews 11 and 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain his brother, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts. And by it, he being dead, yet spake. By faith, Hebrews 11 and 5. By faith, Enoch was translated, taken up out of here, that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony, just the only testimony he had, that he pleased God. That's the only testimony we need, that we please God. Hebrews 11 and 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please God. He that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. Faith. Hebrews 11 and 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whither he went. By faith, he sojourned in a land of promise, as a strange in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles. Look, here's his generation, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. Three generations: Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. 10th verse, Hebrews 11. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is God. He's looking for heaven. Through faith, also Sarah, that old woman, herself, received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child, look, when she was past age, about 100 years old, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Hebrews 11:12, therefore, spring there even of one in him as good as dead, so many as stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the sea show innumerable. These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off and were persuaded of them and embraced them and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country, looking forward to the end of their life for the beginning of their salvation. Hebrews 11:15. And truly, if they had been mindful of that country from which they came out, they might have had opportunity to have returned. But now they desire a better country, that is, an heavenly. Wherefore God is not ashamed, look, to be called their God. For he had prepared for them a city by faith. Abraham, when he was tried, offered up Isaac, and he that had received the promise offered up his only begotten son, of whom it was said that in Isaac shall thy seed be blessed. So he had that promise. You don't have no seed, you're going to have one. When you have a seed, you're going to call him Isaac. And Isaac going to populate the whole earth. Hebrews 11:19. According to that, God was able to raise him up, even from the dead, from which also he received him in a figure. 20th verse in Hebrews 11. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob. And here's what people don't like to read. Hebrews 11:20. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, man dying, still believing on God. Hebrews 11:21. By faith, Jacob, when he was in the process of dying, blessed both the sons. What sons? Joseph and Esau. 21st verse in Hebrews 11. By faith, Jacob, when he was a dying, blessed both the sons of Jacob and worshiped, leaning upon the top of his staff. Couldn't stand, just leaning on that staff. That staff was a type of the Holy Spirit. By faith, Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandments concerning his bones. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents. Why? Because they saw he was a proper child, and they were not afraid
of the king's commandment. Any child born in a certain day was to be destroyed. Hebrews 11:24. By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasure of sin for a season, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt, for he had respect unto the recompense of the reward. By faith, he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible, looking to God that he couldn't even see. Through faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he that destroyeth the firstborn should touch him. By faith, Hebrews 11:29, by faith they passed through the Red Sea as by dry land. There was no water in that Red Sea, which the Egyptians are saying to do, were drowned. Our subject is deliverance, and we in our Bible, Hebrews 11, the 30th verse. By faith, the walls of Jericho, you could set 5 4-horse team rigs up there and race around that water, was so wide. But Hebrews said, in Hebrews 30, by faith the walls of Jericho fell, look, down, not over. You catch a wall big enough to race 4 or 5 teams of horses on that wall. If it fall over, you couldn't get over it. See, God is not logical. He's miraculous. The wall then fall over. It fell straight down in the ground, level with the ground. Now, if Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, it looked like to me we ought to be able to take care of this little teeny weeny problem that we have. What I'm doing, I'm allowing the baby to be a baby. What people do now erroneously, they take the babies and put them in the basement and teach them how to pin the tail on a donkey. That makes them an ass too. When the Bible says, bring up the children in the way they ought to go, how can you bring them up in absence of the word of God? Take him out of the Bible study into a playroom. No, man. The disciples got rebuked by Jesus. Because the little baby, they didn't care who y'all did. You love them. They just come run up on you and kiss you. The little baby's running and hugging Jesus. And the disciples rebuked the little babies and made Jesus angry. Suffer means permit. Permit the little children to come unto me and forbid them not. That ain't just back there. There's a school up there on the street close to us. One little boy, 5 or 6 year old, got a hold to a gun and killed a little girl, 5 or 6 years old. Now, if both of those children had been in Sunday school, never mind, let them go to sleep. They can receive more gospel in 5 minutes than it takes us 2 hours to receive. Because we're going to consider, well, my other pastor said, when the baby's here, they take it and go to sleep. So Jesus said, permit the little children.
Yeah, yeah. to come into me. And forbid them not. Look what he said. For such are the kingdom of God. So you're going to bring a child at church and sit him next to you. Warn him before you leave home. Now, if you act up, I'm going to spank your tail. When children be children, they ain't acting up. They're acting their age. Now, when their grandmother start acting like that, I'm going to call the police. I'm going to call Jesus. Something is wrong because granny has failed. She has failed to hear and obey the leadership of the Holy Spirit. And we got this thing, it's erroneous. We think church is a quiet atmosphere thing. When Jesus said, make a joyful noise, all you land, shout. Amen. With the voice of triumph and say, glory to God. That's the church. You see how quiet certain people got? I know what I'm doing. Just leave me alone. Just leave me alone. God, no. Nobody can come into a Holy Ghost Bible teaching church and interfere with the Bible. Nobody. Nobody. God won't permit. Now we need to get this. He said, permit the little children to come. He said it. Then he made it, flipped it over, and forbid them not. For such, not is in the kingdom, such is the kingdom of God. Hey, when I was a little baby, that had been a couple of years ago, my grandfather was a preacher. And I would lay in the pulpit in front of my grandfather, sucking on a bone of a chicken leg. They take that knuckle off so you can't swallow. And I'm laying down there, both of my legs and feet going, sucking them. Nobody said nothing. I am the only child in that family that is a minister. Other people sitting in the pew, shut up, boy, shut up. You hear the preacher? No, you don't hear the preacher. Freedom. 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 I'm in Hebrews 11. I'm going to start at the 20th verse again in Hebrews 11. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau. They were half brothers, had different mothers. Concerning things to come, by faith, Jacob, when he was dying, bless both the sons of Joseph. Bless both the sons of Joseph and worshiped in the process of dying, leaning on the top of his staff. Dying. Dying. Praising God. Boy, that's a good way to enter the kingdom, man. Hebrews 11:22. By faith, Joseph, when he died. Understand this scripture. Hebrews 11:22. Don't read by faith before Joseph died. Hebrews 11:22 said by faith, Joseph, when he died after he died.
Don't try to correct it. Made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandment concerning his bone after he was dead. Ain't that right, Pastor? Is that what it is?
Amen.
All you got to do is slow down. This book will teach you.
Amen.
It'll teach you. Yeah. My little great baby, about that size, in the driveway the other day, say, Granny, I can do a willie. Will you stand flat up and flip over like that? His granny said, boy, not on this concrete. He said, pew, turn over like that. I said, good God, about it. Just turn, flip over like that and came back. Then he said, I told you. Incredible. I said, Lord, what am I going to do with this boy? Let him be a boy. And when he get a young man, you ain't got to go to jail to get him out. Because when he was a child, you treat him like he was a child.
Amen.
Until a child comes to the knowledge that we think we got, they're not guilty. It says this. Jesus said, permit the little children to come to me. And don't you prevent them. They crawl in his lap, hugging him, kissing him, pulling his beard, just like Sherman do. Hebrews 11, 21. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, look, before he died, in the process of dying, Hebrews 11, 21, bless both the sons of Joseph and worship leaning upon the top of his staff. Now, look at Hebrews 11, 22 and leave it alone. By faith, when he died, didn't you hear the scripture say when Cain killed Abel, Abel's blood spoke up? It talked. Don't put your head to that. You don't want to know what your address is. Leave that alone. Let God become a such a head. Let God be God. I said, let God be God. I said, let God be God. I said, let God be God. We're in Hebrews 11 and we're talking about the 21st verse. By faith, Joseph, when he died. Now, you know English. Died mean done died. He ain't here. Not in the process of dying. When he died, he spoke. Boy, that's a miracle right there. This whole book is a miracle, man. Give God a big hand for that. Now you can't go and order some courses on concordance, and you can't find that in them things. You got to slow down and listen for the voice of God, or you ain't gonna never understand nothing.
Amen.
Dealing with a man now, down in someplace, Atlanta. His intent is to go back to Egypt and find out the beginning of his Jewish roots. What? For what? Your mama's a Jew. Your dad is a Jew. But Romans said, he that is a Jew
is not justified. But he that's a Jew in his heart. When I go back down there, he know about it. He know about it.
Amen.
So black man got brave and said, how long you and your wife been married? He said, we're going to get married in October. And she made a mistake. He sleep off under the cover. Now, you ain't got to say nothing else about that. But when I said that, look at me. I saw some hands reaching. They want the book. They want this book. And I told you about the woman start taking Blackman's picture. Blackman start teaching. The more he teach, the more she opened her legs like that. Blackman lift his eyes to the sky and start praying. Them legs come back together like that. That woman got up and started shouting, thank you, Jesus. The devil will try you.
Amen.
Pat your hand if you don't know what I'm talking about. Both of us down there, 800-900 miles away from our wife, don't know nobody, free day and night, and here come the devil. But you see, we didn't go down there to go to hell. You don't have to drive 800-900 miles to go to hell. Just get boned and don't get boned again. You ain't got set for no effort. Our subject is deliverance, and we're in Hebrews 11. And we hit a nugget here in Hebrews 11:20. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. So Isaac prophesied to Jacob and Esau.
Amen.
This book is a prophecy, saints. By faith, Jacob, when he was a dying, in process of dying, blessed both the sons of Jacob, of Joseph, and worship, leaning upon the top of his staff. Look now, this is a miracle. Hebrews 11:22. Look, you see, the miracle is not in what he did, it's how he did it. Hebrews 11:22. By faith, Joseph. Now don't let this slip you. When he died, that means after he was dead, made mention of his departing of his children of Israel and gave commandment concerning his bone when his body was dead. He spoke from the grave.
Amen.
We always talk about nothing is too hard for God. Well, leave that alone.
Amen.
What do you think? Where do you think the prayer of a sinner come from? A dead soul. Lord, save my soul. My soul is dead, but I'm crying out. You see that, Bridget? It's too big for us. I don't care how many doctor's degrees you got. That's too big. You understand that only with the mind of Christ.
Amen.
That ain't Holy Ghost talk. I said that ain't Holy Ghost talk. Hebrews 11, and we hit this nugget here, and I ain't moving. Hebrews 11:22, by Joseph,
by faith Joseph. Look, when he died, after he was dead, made mention of the departing of his children, of the children of Israel, and gave commandments concerning his bones, though his soul was alive. Bones don't talk, the soul talk. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of the parents, of his parents, because they saw he was a proper child. And they were not afraid of the king's commandment. As a matter of fact, the king's daughter adopted Moses. Huh?
Amen.
And when Moses got 40, he told him, I'm out of here. I ain't no Greek. I'm going home. Y'all listening?
Amen.
Now listen to me. If you are the king's daughter's son, you can't need for nothing. But 40 years went by. And God spoke to Moses. Go home. Go home. Go home. And this wasn't just a little BB shooting soldier. There had never been a soldier greater than Moses. See what gets certain people's attention? 22nd verse in Hebrews 11. By faith, Joseph. Read the next 3 words with me. When he died. That means after he was dead. Now, I ain't going to stretch that, but I don't think you saw that before. That's why you here. That's why you here. Now, I confess to you, I didn't see it neither. This book says study to show yourself crucified. When you come to this Bible college with a hunger to see God better, it's the Holy Spirit's responsibility to pull the blind off of your eyes. Come on here. What does that say to us when things seem to be impossible? When things seem to be illogical, they just right with God. I heard a man tell a woman, if you're so pretty, how come you ain't married? She turned around and told him, because I'm pretty. She wasn't talking about on the inside. She was talking about what the man was looking at. Her body. I ain't married because I am beautiful. Now what can that say? If you tiptoed, pad-toed, knock-kneed, cross-eyed, slew-foot beautiful, you have a hard time trying to find a husband.
Amen.
You ain't like Susie that put that cot sack down and Friday was married Sunday and been married 75 years. I tell you how come it's like that. Susie been ugly all her life. And she admits it.
Susanna was born beautiful. She'll see herself as beautiful. And men will marry that beautiful. But in 20 years, you ain't the woman he married. Because he's looking at how you were. Pat your hand to that with your jive self. But if you're beautiful in Jesus, my Bible said Jesus is the same, yeah. Today, and forevermore. That's how rehab was justified. Because she did good to the men of God. She wouldn't tell the other people that they was hiding. That's beauty. And God opened the doors of heaven to her. And when you get there, you're going to see her. And I'm going to tell you something else. I can't say it for nobody but her and me. When you get to heaven, wait 2 or 3 million years and then ask him out. You seen Jane? Yeah, he over there on his knees. What's he praying for? He worshiping God. How long he been worshiping God? Eternity, Jesus, so long. You mean he still loved Jesus? There's nothing ordinary with Jesus. You see the peace in this room that the devil tried to translate it as confusion?
Amen.
Love never fails. And we don't get things right, man. The Lord said, love ye one another.
Amen.
He didn't say, except you be a child. Except you be a baby. If Jesus come for his church right now, I would whole lot rather be like that baby there than some of us. You see, I'm an old man. And certain things that irritate other folk bless me. Ha ha! Ha! It bless me. I'm in Hebrews 11 teaching the subject deliverance. And I'm going to start at Hebrews 11:19. I'm going to start at Hebrews 11:17. By faith, Abraham, when he was tried, hold it right there. Do you see what you need when you're tried? Not tongues. Not the Holy Ghost. Not scripture. Faith is the keeping power of God's people. And faith is a positive proclamation in spite of all hell. Peter saw Jesus walk that water. Looking right at him. Here's what he did that crippled his face. He said, Lord, if that be you. Ha, 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 ha! Preposition. Not help me, but permit me to come. When you talk to Gamayasatanah, when you talk to God, you need to know how to approach God in the name of Jesus. I prayed for 3 days, Lord, fix my lawnmower. All four of my lawnmowers are dead, including that $5,000 zero turn. I approached God the wrong way. I said, Lord, show me how to fix my lawnmowers so I can cut your grass. That's a bribery. 3 or 4 days I've been saying that. Went to see my son, Gracie Emanuel, associate pastor over there. I told him, he said, call this man here and tell him I told you to call him. I called him. That man stopped what he was doing, came over here, took those 3 blades off of my lawnmower, turned them over, and the one in the middle, shaka, 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 shaka. I ran over one of them rugs you see when you come in the door out there, and I broke one of the shakas loose. 3 other blades were turning, the one in the middle, I broke the shaft. So, raka, raka, raka. That man came out, he older than me. Got down on his knee. Now, see, she don't go down. When you older than me, you old. He said, I think one of my sisters or something died. He said, I can't fix it, but I'm going to let this man fix it for you. Go this place and all of this thing here. I went there. I said, Lord, how come you didn't answer my prayer? He said, what prayer? You were asking me, Lord, help me. I ain't a mechanic. Keep it simple. Lord, fix my lawnmower. Thank you. So when I came to the end, Pastor, see, look, when God don't answer my prayer like I want him answered, tears start coming out of my eyes. Because I realize, Pastor, you ain't asking right. Now we need to know, without the Holy Spirit, we don't know how to talk to God. Come on here. I just heard a scripture. Jesus said, the day you hear my voice, hey, my Satan, hey, hard not your heart as in the day of provocation. When they tried me and saw my judgment 400 years. What I'm telling you, the Bible is right when it tells us cast all your care upon God. He care for you. I wasn't praying, I was begging. Lord, help me fix this lawnmower. Look at the con game. So I can cut your grass. Now you can't bring street talk to God. You can't bring street talk to God. But you can bring sweet talk to God. So I started looking back. I said, Lord, when I was on my way to New York to play a concert and went to sleep with my car on cruise. Then I went to sleep and about to hit the viaduct and you woke me up. See, look, you got to tell God, you got to bring God to your memory of how good he been. Amen. Then you come to the scripture, he's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. You can't con God. Amen. We are sweetly hung up on a miracle. I don't know why preachers try to teach miracles in the New Testament. Jesus Christ is saying yesterday, today, what? And forever. Don't put him in a box. Tune it verse. Hebrews 11. By faith, Isaac, look at this word, blessed Jacob, and he blessed Esau concerning thing to come. He prophesied to them. Amen. And that prophet was a blessing. It was a guideline. It showed them which way they're supposed to go, what's going to happen, what position they're going to be in, what the king going to do, what the queen going to do. But look what God going to do. Come on here. When did he do that? When he was in the process of dying. He preached the gospel till his last breath, preacher. Amen. Hey! Till he died, he was preaching the gospel. But the Methodists or some other churches, Pastor Blackman told me, when you get 65, they fire you. You can't pastor no more. How you gonna retire a saint? Do you see Joseph and Isaac and Jacob? They preached Jesus until their last breath. In Hebrews 11:22, by faith, Joseph, when he died, still instructed the church. Listen now and learn. His body just died. He became alive. His spirit preached the things he knew before his body died. My subject is deliverance. And I'm teaching Hebrews 11. Hebrews 11:22. Now the first two words that you see in all these scriptures, by faith. Faith enabled to him to. But faith alone is dead. Faith in God spoke to Joseph. Faith in God spoke to Jacob. Faith in God spoke to Isaiah. Faith in God speak to us. Faith is the conversation of God. And faith come by hearing, and hearing by this word of God. So when you read God's word, God spoke to you then. So the word of God is nothing less than God laid down flat. When you have faith in a laid down God, that faith would take that laying down God and stand him up. By faith we stand. Without faith we fall. Faith is God. Hey there. Faith is God. We're teaching deliverance now, and
We are in Hebrews 11. I'm going to start at the 17th verse again because I'm getting blessed up here.
Amen.
What I am receiving is revelation from God as to what faith really is and what faith is designed to do for the faithful. Amen. So faith comes to anchor you. And if you keep reading this word from that anchor position, you can speak glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Faith is the savior, the keeper, the inspirer, the teacher, the substance of things what? Hope for in the evidence what? Of things not seen. Faith is all of this. And these patriarchs, they saw all of it. They saw more faith than we can see. And they wrote it. What you need to do now, look here. You can look out there and see faith. But faith cometh. Faith from out there can look here and see us. So faith that you can look and see, and faith that can see you, gives us a faith walk. God said it, that serves it. Glory to God. That's the way it works, man. That's the way it works. Now I need to get real, man. Things don't have to be right for us to live holy. As a matter of fact, when we make up our mind, I ain't doing that sin now kind of more again. Here comes Satan. Ooh. You know you've been admiring that dress for 4 years. God don't mind if he could take your tithe and pay for that. God on that, you better pay your tithes. I say you pay your tithes. Not paying tithes is a key that opened the door of hell. You can't rob God. It is impossible. I'm going to keep telling you this stuff, man. I was on my way to New York City to play a country when I was a young preacher on one of them jets. And I saw an angel. I looked out the window and saw an angel. The angel was so much bigger than that airplane until it took him 15 minutes to pass by. And I wanted to say, did you see? No. See, hey, what God showed you is for you. And God only show you good deeds. And the scripture said, make known the good deeds of the Lord among the people. I ain't gonna never forget that. And I was praying and got caught up in the Holy Ghost. And I left my body and went right there to the doors of heaven. I could see the glory shining through the crack. And I was going to jump in there like that and woke myself up. I said, Lord, oh God. I heard God say, it's not time. That's been 40 years ago. I've already outlived Paul, Peter, John, those people. But here I am at 82, reading what those young men wrote over 2,000 years ago. It is simply amazing. And I've been studying a long time, but I didn't know Hebrews 11:22. You didn't need it. Don't be lying in here.
by faith Joseph when he died, after he was dead.
Yep.
Well, how come that's so amazing when on earth God don't speak to your flesh? So when the Holy Ghost put his fingers in the ears of your flesh and you start seeking God with your heart, don't rush God. Now don't go home and tell God, now Lord, Pastor Wheeler said, you seek the Lord for you. You can do it better for you than I can for you. And once God touched your stuff, nobody can tell it like you. Oh, nobody! Nobody can tell it like you. And you'll be saying, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I'm going to tell you again. I prayed for 3 days for God to show me how to fix those lawnmowers. God didn't show me nothing but another minister, my son, Jeff. And I went to Jeff's church to give him a few dollars to help him with his son's wedding. And I told my son about this lawnmower. He said, call this number. I called that number. That man's something busy, but I'll be there. Just like that, he came to do this. Learn the scripture. Learn. Just don't put them in your head.
Pastor Dr. James M. Wheeler here, president and founder of Mighty FGCC Bible College Theological Seminary in this country and abroad. 48 colleges spread it throughout, nothing but the Word of God. I pastor the Full Gospel Christian Church at 5901 Dr. Martin Luther King and Home Avenue, 3 blocks north of Pearson Road, where you're always welcome. On this television station every Sunday morning from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m., every Wednesday night from 9 to 11 p.m. Sunday school, 9:30, morning service, 11 o'clock, evening service, 7 p.m. Tuesday, Bible college from 7 to 10, one night, 3 hours, rather than 3 nights, 1 hour. Thursday night, both study and prayer. We're on WFLT every Sunday morning at 8, every Saturday morning at 11. This is a place where you hear nothing but the Word of God. Come.
We're glad to have our young baby students with us. We want this to act like a real church, real people, not shh people, but hallelujah people. We're going to be teaching out of the textbook now, and Deliverance, you don't need your textbook if you follow me. The lesson is found on page 2. In the Deliverance book. And I will be quoting some scriptures and teaching some scriptures from page 2 in the Deliverance book. We're going to start teaching on page
on Hebrews 11 and 1. And our subject is to be called the deliverance. And we're going to read Hebrews 11, and we're going to see faith and the patriarchs of faith and how God recognized and how God deal with faith. Hebrews 1. There's a time element there. Now, Hebrews 11 and 1. Now, faith is the substance of the things hoped for. Faith is the evidence of things not seen. For by faith, the elders obtain a good report. Hebrews 11 and 3. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hebrews 11 and 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, his brother, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts. And by it, he being dead, yet spake. By faith, Hebrews 11 and 5. By faith, Enoch was translated, taken up out of here, that he should not see death. And was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony, just the only testimony he had, that he pleased God. That's the only testimony we need, that we please God. Hebrews 11 and 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please God. He that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. Faith. Hebrews 11 and 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after for an inheritance,